adding emergency shelter blueprints to your databank. With the Builder tool, you can construct sea bases from raw materials, advising against exploring a frozen water continent without a base. No bed, no storage, no place to put a fabricator module. No fun.
Will this help us build you a body?
I do not know what we will find. I just know it is important.
Signal location uploaded to PDA.
You're trespassing. If you know what's good for you, you'll get the hell out of here.
Fred, great to see you. Come on in. You don't mind if I record this, do you? Am I in trouble?
No. You know me. Just a fanatic for details. And my memory's not what it used to be.
I know what that's like.
Yes. Is that why you've been running so many personal errands for your colleagues? We asked you to limit them.
So I am in trouble.
That's not how I want you to look at it. Here's what I see. You're a team player. You want to get the job done.
I think I have a pretty good record there.
You want people to like you.
Has anyone complained?
Fred, the trouble is, not everyone is as reliable as you are. Sometimes people need help being where they need to be and concentrating on their work.
All the trips were work-related.
It appears you transported tech for Lil, rather far out from her base.
Lil needed to go deep, and she needed a sea truck.
Her work is currently on surface installations. She shouldn't be anywhere near the water. No more favors to friends, agreed?
Yes, sir.
I keep telling you. Call me Manu.
Then your position is doubly precarious.
What do you mean?
If you're telling the truth, you're out of your mind. If you're lying, there'll be hell to pay.
Wait! Who are you?
Stay off my land.
The woman in the exosuit has been traced as far as my technology will allow.
In the future, I hope you will avoid contact with the woman in the exosuit. I am among the last of a dying civilization. If you were to compromise your well-being, the species could go extinct.
What makes you think she's hostile anyway? A little grumpy maybe, but who wouldn't be, stranded out here alone?
She did not respond to my distress call. And she is well-armed.
Maybe she's afraid of us.
I have no desire to find out.
Signal location uploaded to PDA.
For the last time, I'm not cheating.
Then what's your theory? What's going on?
If you ask me, Zeta's been blinking a lot. I think it's a tell.
He does have a point there.
It's allergies.
Allergies? Oh, is something in bloom in this frozen sector?
Thermal lilies. And if you gang up on me, I swear you're all fired.
You're not even my boss.
Oh, you're all so gullible. You're fighting each other. Meanwhile, look at Pavan. Just look at him.
What am I doing? I'm not doing anything.
Let's just take this to a vote. All those who think Zeta's allergies are a bad case of alienitis, say intruder.
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 Intruder. Danny?
Oh, I'm just an observer here.
I'm going to use my pass.
Is there some kind of scientist conspiracy going on here? Zeta, Sam, Danielle, you three are suddenly very aligned.
Or, like I said, Parvin is cheating.
I'm starting to wish I was cheating.
Communications tower maintenance log. Another day, another slight by the winged furies. As usual, I got an interference alert. As usual, I went out to see what the problem was. As usual, it was frozen stalagmites of feathered... But I could swear they're targeting me personally. The week I was out with the flu, I came back to find the tower spotless. Parvin laughed at me when I asked him how he cleaned it. Silly me. As if Parvin would ever clean anything. There's nothing left for me to do but quit. But I know that's what the birds want me to do. Oh, and I got the tower up and running. Maintenance complete.
Jenny, you wouldn't believe the adventure I'm having. It's just like when we were kids and we used to play underwater city, only... Sea monsters aren't pretend, and I don't need to hide behind you when one swims by. Because I'm safe in my sea truck. Safe and Very, very brave. Please tell Dad for me. Thanks so much for the mustache kit, by the way. To be honest, I wasn't sure if it was a gag gift at first. Personal grooming is something of a challenge here, and as you know, I'm a pretty low-maintenance guy to begin with. But you'd be surprised how handy mustache wax is in an emergency. There have been some close scrapes. For a while there, someone was sabotaging my truck, and I thought I was seeing things. But my friend Sam helped me sort it out. Although, she's had some troubles of her own lately. To be honest, I get a little worried out here sometimes. But I guess that's normal, under the circumstances. Gotta expect a little risk, right? I should be happy. I have great friends and a good paycheck. Anyway, love you, Jenny, and Dad. Please find a way to tell him that he won't find embarrassing. And don't worry, I'm looking for the perfect fish to bring back as a gift. Your favorite!
Good morning, Frostpack. Just a quick update to inform you of some key achievements and priority shifts we need you all to get behind. The Spy Pangling Project was a resounding success. Please join me in congratulating Samantha IU, who is now reassigned to Outpost Zero, helping us dream of future initiatives. Congratulations are also in order for Danielle Valenti and her team at Omega Lab. The closing of Phi Robotics means important funds can be redirected to their Kara bacteria study, which has important, positive implications for the life sciences. You're all doing an exceptional job, and I don't want to promise anything, but HQ has been taking notice. Keep up the good work, and I think we can start discussing bonuses soon.
Sam really got under management's skin. I didn't know she had it in.
Ospack is making excellent progress. I must say, my management style appears to be uniquely well-suited to isolated planets. I miss you, of course, but I wonder if you feel it too. As great as we are together, we're almost better apart. Just look at how well Prosperina did in her last show. I'm sorry I couldn't be there to see it, but I'm sure if I'd been around, I'd only have made her nervous. Once this mission is over, I'll come home for a few good months. And then, what do you think if we look at reorganizing our expectations to facilitate longer-term separation success? I really think this could be a great model for us going forward, romantically and otherwise. Don't forget, I love you from the depths of my heart. Keep on succeeding in your projects. You know there's nothing I find more attractive.
Tower maintenance log. Okay, this time the birds have really done it. I don't know what they've been eating, but it's corrosive when it comes out the other end. I'm gonna need to rewire. I'm short an element to fabricate the right cable. I remember seeing someone who did that dive to the old ship. I'm gonna go out there and see if I can get some more. That should fix it. Maintenance status, in progress.
I'm glad it could help.
I know you would still prefer me to have a corporeal form of my own.
Well, yes.
If you continue searching, I may regain some of my connection to the network, piece by piece. As data, we are all aware of each other's thoughts and needs. Scientific endeavors are accomplished much more smoothly this way.
There's more to life than research, Alan. I can't lie. Work would go faster if I could read my colleagues' minds, but thoughts are private, and people have their own inner lives. People change and need space to think.
Space helps you think. I find that being separated from my network is very quiet.
What do you mean by quiet?
Imagine 1,000 strings, each playing its own range of notes, none louder than the others. Each one builds harmony, a continuous thrum in the background of existence. I am now a lone string in search of familiar harmonies.
I'll help you find them.
Thank you.
allow you to survey the surrounding region for fragments and material resources like lithium or copper or titanium if you need help finding it. For whatever reason.
Emergency power only. Oxygen production offline.